Welcome back, dear students. So myself Nympha Maskindas and I am your biology lecturer. So as you all know, we are dealing with chapter 2. Okay, in case of chapter 2, we saw about all the different basic needs or necessities of biological classification. Okay, and apart from this, we also had a differentiation of five kingdom classification. Okay, so your five kingdom classification are nothing but kingdom Monera, kingdom Protista, kingdom Fungi, kingdom Plantae, and kingdom Animalia. Okay, and make sure you keep one thing in point that this five kingdom classification is given by R. H. Whittaker. Okay, and in the previous videos we have dealt with kingdom Monera and kingdom Protista in detail, and in this class we'll be dealing in detail with kingdom Fungi. Okay, so fungi are nothing but they can be also called as fungus. Okay, fungi, fungus, okay, everything you can call them. So, I guess everyone has seen what fungi actually looks like. Okay, not under microscope. At least in your normal kitchen, in your house, day to day kitchen, normal life, I guess you have seen what fungus actually looks like. Okay, I guess you can have the imagination of you leave something bread, okay, you get certain bread and you leave it as it is. Then you see certain greenish molds on the bread, okay, those are nothing but those are called as fungal molds. Okay, so this is how you can see, and apart from that also, okay, even in case of rice, okay, if it is delayed or if it is kept as it is outside for a longer period, it gets a very bad smell, right? Okay, that is all smelling due to the activity of certain fungus and bacteria in it. Okay, so that's how we see fungus, and due to this we basically observe the growth of fungus to take in a very higher manner in case of very warm and humid condition. Okay, warm and humid condition in the sense means that very high temperature, okay, very warm temperature, which is around 35-36 degrees Celsius. Okay, this warm temperature and humidity over here is nothing but the atmosphere air consists of lot more water vapors. This particular environment can be called as humid environment. Okay, and here the growth of fungus is accelerated when there is warm and humid environment. Okay, this is how the growth takes place, and that's why to prevent the growth of fungus, to prevent the decaying of our food material, what we do, we keep our food into refrigerators. Okay, this is just because we lower down the temperature. Okay, if at all there are certain bacteria into the food which we have prepared, okay, we keep that food into refrigerator just to lower down the temperature of the food so that none of the fungal growth are seen. Because when fungus arises, that food is no longer processed for eating. Okay, that's why it may cause certain fungal infection, and due to this we prevent certain food from decaying, okay, from deteriorating by keeping into refrigerators. Okay, this is clear. I hope you got the idea what fungus actually are. Okay, so in last classes, okay, let me remind you about five kingdom classification. So talking about five kingdom classification, you all actually know that there are either two kinds of organisms, right? One is prokaryotic and other is eukaryotic. Okay, prokaryotic are the one which belong to kingdom Monera, right? All the prokaryotic organisms are grouped into kingdom Monera. Whereas the problem is with eukaryotic organism, because there is a vast majority of eukaryotic organisms, okay, and of which the unicellular eukaryotic organism consists of kingdom Protista. Okay, rest all the three kingdoms which are left now, fungi, plantae, animalia, these are also multicellular eukaryotic organisms, right? So we got a confusion over here. How to further differentiate, right? To clear your confusion, I told you in my previous video that kingdom fungi consists of multicellular eukaryotic organism, but their cell wall composition differs from plant cell wall composition, right? So now, just to remind you, we are only left with three kingdoms, of which these three kingdoms are both eukaryotic and multicellular. okay, that is kingdom fungi, plantae and animalia. Over here, only plants and fungi have cell wall. Okay, sorry, only plants and fungi have cell wall. But animals do not have cell wall, they only have cell membrane. So it is easy, we can cut off animals from here. So now we are left with two kingdoms, that is fungi and plantae. So now how to differentiate between them? Okay, on the basis of cell wall. If the cell wall is made up of cellulose, then we can call them as plants. And if the cell wall is made up of chitin or any polysaccharide, we can call them as fungi. Okay, I hope this doubt is clear to everyone. And I wish everyone remembers five kingdom classification till the end of your life. Because you have taken biology and this is the must system that you remember all the animals in this very easy manner. Is it clear? So all the animals in this universe fall under these five kingdoms. Okay, and here in this video lecture, we will be studying about the third kingdom, that is called as fungi. Okay, so coming back to the characters, you can see I have written mycology. Okay, the study of fungus itself is called as mycology. Okay, and then these are, as I have told you, these are multicellular eukaryotic organisms, except yeast. Okay, I guess everyone know what yeast are. Okay, yeast are nothing but these are certain fungal cells which are used into baking of the bread, preparing of the beverages like wines, alcohol beverages like wines and beers. Okay, here in preparation of this, yeast are used. Okay, yeast are nothing but these are different from fungus a little bit because these are unicellular, but these are eukaryotic. Is it clear? Okay. But here, these yeast also have certain cell wall made up of chitin. That's why they are placed into kingdom Monera. Okay? Yes. So next is the third composition or third point is their cell wall. Okay? Cell wall in case of fungus is made up of chitin or it can be also made up of certain kind of polysaccharides. Okay? Polysaccharides are nothing but these are the constituents are made by many kind of monosaccharides. Monosaccharide is single sugar. Okay, if many sugars are clumped together, they form polysaccharide. And here, the cell wall of fungus is made up of polysaccharide. Okay, so next is about their structures. Okay, this particular thing is quite very important. That's why I have drawn a diagram over here. Okay, this thing is very important because, okay, I will just tell you. First, coming back to the next one, that is cosmopolitan in distribution. Okay, cosmopolitan in distribution andre, these are found each and everywhere. Okay, fungus are the one which are found each and everywhere. Okay, be it air, be it soil, be it water, be it on plants, animals. Each and everywhere you find fungus, that's why these are cosmopolitan in distribution. Niviel Bekadali Hudakri. Okay, you everywhere find fungus, that's why Navenantivi, fungus are cosmopolitan in distribution. Okay, next coming back to the most important things of kingdom fungi. Okay, make sure you understand these terms very clearly. Because the rest of the further video will be, I'll be using these all technical words. That's why make sure you just open up your minds and listen to these words, what they actually mean. Okay, so when you talk about fungi, you always come across a word called as hyphae. Okay, hyphae are nothing but these are the branchings which are seen into the body of a fungi. For example, okay, you can imagine a fungi which is called as agaricus, a mushroom fungi. Okay, mushroom anta commonly hear tevi, mushroom na imagine maadi. Okay, mushroom ni cut open maadi daga, you can see certain lines or branches into it, right? See, if at all you haven't seen mushrooms yet, you can do one thing, you can Google about mushroom. Okay, mushroom photo bandaga, you can see certain branches in that. Okay, and that particular branches are called as hyphae. Okay, hyphae are nothing but these are the branches which are found into the body of fungi. Okay, and then coming back to the end result. Okay, these hyphae further into certain other different branches. Okay, further more complex branches are seen, and those are not nothing but those are called as mycelium. Okay, so here these all branch structures are called as hyphae, and hyphae ends into this particular branching structures called as mycelium. Okay, and then nothing but cnocytic hyphae. Okay, I'll just draw a little diagram over here. See this part mycelium, I'll just continue it over here. Okay, take one mycelium. Okay, so here what you can imagine is, I have just cut this part, okay, and I have placed it at the microscope. Okay, under microscope, this particular branching of mycelium appears to be like this. Okay, and here, if this branching is multinucleated, okay, multinucleated andre enu, more number of nucleus is present. Okay, if this mycelium consists of many nucleus, okay, so this particular structure we can call it as cnocytic hyphae or as coenocytic hyphae 2. Okay, is it clear? Okay, so I will repeat again. There are certain branching structures into the body of a fungi. Those are called as hyphae. And these hyphae end into many more branch, complex branching called as mycelium. When we take the section of mycelium, we observe certain nucleus, multinucleated stage, and that particular is called as cnocytic or coenocytic hyphae. Okay, and on the basis of mycelium, if branchings are more, okay, ille branching in tavala, bhaal complex branching in tandre, we call it as aseptic. But one or two branching in tandre, we call it as septate. Okay, I have just placed certain diagrams so that you can observe and understand very clearly what are aseptic and septate mycelium or hyphae. Is it clear? So these are the technical words which I request basically, so that you can remember, because the rest of the video is on the basis of these technical words. Okay, so if you wish, I'll repeat this again. You can listen it back over here. Okay, there are certain words called as hyphae. Hyphae are nothing but even branchings body da bartavalla, aa branchings na naavu hyphae anta karitevi. Okay, matte enagutade, ee hyphae ends into further sub branches. Okay, mat kelage enen branches bartavalla, root kind of structure, aa root igna naavu mycelium anta karitevi. Okay, matte mycelium valag, if we see many nucleus, okay, multinucleated stage it andre, we call it as coenocytic or cnocytic hyphae. Okay, cnocytic hyphae anta karitevi. Next, okay, mycelium akismat bhaal rooting ittandre, bhaal branches complex ittandre, nave en antarithivi, aseptate antivi. Okay, if branches bhaal kadme, like okay, somewhat we can observe very clearly andre, we can say septate hyphae. Is it clear? So this is about the structure of a fungi. So I just request everyone to keep these things in mind. Okay, so next, coming back to the mode of nutrition. So nutrition is nothing but these are totally heterotrophic. Okay, this is also another differentiation between kingdom plantae and kingdom fungi. Kingdom plantae are totally autotrophic because they have chlorophyll pigment, they synthesize their own food. But here kingdom fungi are heterotrophic. They depend on other organisms for their food. Okay, but basically in case of heterotrophic mode, we see these are saprophytes. Saprophytes andre, they are always found into dead and decaying matters. Okay, yell dead leaves irtav, dead animals irtav. Okay, all now fungus growth note. Okay, that's why we call it as saprophytic mode of nutrition, feeding on the dead and decaying organic matter. Okay, and then you see parasitic mode. Parasitic mode is kind of easy and jolly way of life. Easy way of life because just to rely on other animal, going inside the body of other animal or going on the outer surface of other animal and enjoying your life over there. All the basic needs of your life are processed by other animal or depending on the other animal, that is called as parasitic. Okay, and then next is the symbionts. Symbionts are nothing but mutual understanding mele now grow aagukke symbionts anta karitevi or symbiotic association anta helbodu. Okay, symbiotic association dag en aagutadandra, just for example neevu nim friend ig one pen kodtivi, okay, one pen kodri ant tilkori, next time he returns you two pens, en aagtidi, full khushi aagtiri, how do I know? Okay, that is nothing but you have certain relationship. One relationship anna form madidini neevu. Neevu one pen kottaga they return you back with two pens. You are happier, he is also happier. Okay, here what you say? Mutual understanding. Okay, mutual. Maatadkondu neenu benefit aagripa, naavu benefit aagtevi. Okay, that is kind of mutual relationship. So mutual relationship is seen in case of symbionts. Okay, in case of symbionts also we see two kinds, that is lichens and mycorrhiza. Okay, lichens are nothing but all the fungus associated with algae are called as lichens, whereas all the fungus associated with the roots of higher plants are called as mycorrhiza. Okay, lichens because in antevi alli alga anka nam gottide, that belongs to kingdom plantae. Okay, kingdom plantae alli enen bartavalla, they are autotrophic andre they prepare their own food. Ill en martavante fungus en martidi hogi algae could association torustu. Okay, algae they prepare food and fungus what they do, they give shelter to the algae. So idena agithe mutual relationship, fungus over here give shade to algae, algae in the sense give food for the fungus. Illena agithe mutual relationship. Is it clear? So this is how they are called as lichens. And next is mycorrhiza. Mycorrhiza andre they are present at the roots of the plant. Okay, in the diagram you can see roots of the plant andre roots obviously soil valage irthada. Okay, soil valage you see all the nutrients larger particles ittandre plant ek problem aagutha, smaller particles dag break up maadi mat body valage tagoli. That's why fungus are hogi en martadandre larger particles na break down maadi smaller particles martad taavu tintara mat plants igu kodta. Okay, this is how they enjoy their life over there, and that is called as mycorrhizae. And here they help in fixing nitrogen. Okay, all these things they help, and the plant benefits from that, and even the fungus benefits. That is called as symbiotic association or the mutual relationship, which we see in case of fungus. Okay, this is all about nutrition, mode of nutrition. And next coming back to reproduction. Okay, when we talk about reproduction, we see three modes of reproduction over here. That is vegetative. Okay, vegetative mode of reproduction is by fragmentation. Fragmentation andre one fragments are gonna cut. Okay, like this. If the fragments are gonna cut, okay, each fragment goes into a new body. That is called as fragmentation. Fission. Okay, fission is also division. Okay, and budding. Budding andre if there is one fungus over here that gives a bud off. Bud andre a small extra body surface, outer body surface, that is called as bud. Okay, a bud cut off agi goes into formation of a new body, that is called as budding. Okay, and then coming back to asexual mode of reproduction, over here we see conidia, okay, sporangiospores, okay, zoospores. Okay, all these are nothing but these are relevant to spore formation. Okay, asexual mode of reproduction is only by spore formation. Spore formation andre okay, ig now favorable conditions tak ade we can grow anyhow by vegetative and sexual mode. If unfavorable condition is there, okay, say for example refrigerator dage ne bhaal like for a month one food item na bitirthiri, obviously avaga food consume martiri amele madudilla yakandre idena fungal mat microorganisms irtavalla avu spore formation martta. Unfavorable condition, that is favorable condition andre warm climate and humid temperature. ಓಕೆ ಹ್ಯೂಮಿಡ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ವಾರ್ಮ್ ಟೆಂಪ್ರೇಚರ್ ಇತ್ತಂದರೆ ದೇ ಗ್ರೋ. ಇಫ್ ಕೋಲ್ಡರ್ ಕ್ಲೈಮೇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ದೇ, ದೆನ್ ವಾಟ್ ಡೆ ಡೂ, ದೇ ಸ್ಟಾಪ್ ಗ್ರೋಯಿಂಗ್? ನೋ. ಇನ್ ದ ಸೆನ್ಸ್ ವಾಟ್ ದೇ ಡೂ ಇಸ್ ದೇ ಫಾರ್ಮ್ ಸರ್ಟನ್ ಸ್ಪೋರ್ಸ್. ಸ್ಪೋರ್ಸ್ ಅಂದರೆ ಇಫ್ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಫಂಗಲ್ ಸೆಲ್ಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ದೇ ಕವರ್ ಬೈ ಅ ಥಿಕ್ ಕೋಟ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಆ ಸ್ಪೋರಾಂಜಿಯಂ. ಓಕೆ, ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಹೌ ದಿಸ್ ಫಾರ್ಮ್ ಸರ್ಟನ್ ಸ್ಪೋರ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದೀಸ್ ಸ್ಪೋರ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ರಿಸರ್ವ್ ವೆನ್ ದ ಫೇವರೇಬಲ್ ಕಂಡೀಷನ್ಸ್ ರೀಚ್ ಬ್ಯಾಕ್. ಓಕೆ, ಒನ್ ಮಂತ್ ಆದಮೇಲೆ ನೀವು ಫುಡ್ನ ರೆಫ್ರಿಜರೇಟರಿಂದ ಹೊರಗೆ ತೆಗಿತೀರಿ ತಿನ್ಬೇಕನ್ಕೊಂಡು, ಅವಾಗೇನು ಮಾಡ್ತೀರಿ? ಅವಾಗಿಂದ ಅವಾಗ ತಕ್ಷಣ ತಿನ್ನಂಗಿಲ್ಲ ಆಬ್ವಿಯಸ್ಲಿ, ಯಾಕಂದರೆ ಭಾಳ ಕೋಲ್ಡ್ ಇರ್ತದೆ. ವಿ ಕೀಪ್ ಇಟ್ ಫಾರ್ ಸಮ್ಟೈಮ್ಸ್. ಓಕೆ, ಆ ಸಮ್ಟೈಮ್ಸ್ ಏನು ನಾವು ಇಡ್ತೇವಲ್ಲ, ಫೇವರೇಬಲ್ ಕಂಡೀಷನ್ ವಾಪಸ್ ಬಂದಾಗ ಸ್ಪೋರ್ಸ್ ಬ್ರೇಕ್ ಓಪನ್ ಮತ್ತು ಡಬಲ್ ಫಂಗಲ್ ಕಾಲೋನಿ ಫಾರ್ಮ್ ಆಗ್ತದೆ. ಓಕೆ, ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಅ ನ್ಯೂ ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್ ಬಾಡೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ಫಾರ್ಮ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಅ ಮೋಡ್ ಆಫ್ ಎ ಸೆಕ್ಷುವಲ್ ರೀಪ್ರೊಡಕ್ಷನ್. ಇಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಕ್ಲಿಯರ್? ಓಕೆ, ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಕಮಿಂಗ್ ಬ್ಯಾಕ್ ಟು ಸೆಕ್ಷುವಲ್ ಮೋಡ್ ಆಫ್ ರೀಪ್ರೊಡಕ್ಷನ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೆಕ್ಷುವಲ್ ಮೋಡ್ ಆಫ್ ರೀಪ್ರೊಡಕ್ಷನ್ ಈಸ್ ಯೂನಿಯನ್ ಆಫ್ ಮೇಲ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಫಿಮೇಲ್ ಗ್ಯಾಮೆಟ್ಸ್. ಓಕೆ, ಮೇಲ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಫಿಮೇಲ್ಸ್ ಫೋರ್ ಯೂನಿಯನ್ ಆತಂದರೆ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಮೋಡ್ ಆಫ್ ಸೆಕ್ಷುವಲ್ ರೀಪ್ರೊಡಕ್ಷನ್. ಓಕೆ, ದೀಸ್ ಆಲ್ ಆರ್ ದ ಟರ್ಮ್ಸ್ ರಿಲೆವೆಂಟ್ ಟು ಸೆಕ್ಷುವಲ್ ಮೋಡ್ ಆಫ್ ರೀಪ್ರೊಡಕ್ಷನ್, ವಿಚ್ ಆರ್ ಹೂಸ್ ಫೋರ್ಸ್, ಆಸ್ಕೋ ಸ್ಪೋರ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಬ್ಯಾಸಿಡಿಯೋ ಸ್ಪೋರ್ಸ್. ಇಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಕ್ಲಿಯರ್? ಸೊ ದೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ದ ಸ್ಪೋರ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಸೆಕ್ಷುವಲ್ ಮೋಡ್ ಆಫ್ ರೀಪ್ರೊಡಕ್ಷನ್. ಐ ಹೋಪ್ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಕ್ಲಿಯರ್ ಫಾರ್ ಯು ಆಲ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಆನ್ ದ ಬೇಸಿಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಜನರಲ್ ಕ್ಯಾರೆಕ್ಟರ್ಸ್ ವಿಚ್ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಸೀನ್, ದೇರ್ ಆರ್ ಫೋರ್ ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್ ಡಿವಿಷನ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಗ್ರೂಪ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಕಿಂಗ್ಡಮ್ ಫಂಜೈ. ಓಕೆ, ದೋಸ್ ಆರ್ ಫೈಕೋಮೈಸಿಟೀಸ್, ಆಸ್ಕೋಮೈಸಿಟೀಸ್, ಬ್ಯಾಸಿಡಿಯೋಮೈಸಿಟೀಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಡ್ಯೂಟೆರೋಮೈಸಿಟೀಸ್. ಇಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಕ್ಲಿಯರ್? ಸೊ ಇನ್ ದ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಕಮಿಂಗ್ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ ಯು ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಸ್ಟಡಿಂಗ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ಆಲ್ ದಿಸ್ ಡಿವಿಷನ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ಡೀಟೇಲ್. ಓಕೆ, ಲೆಟ್ಸ್ ಮೂವ್ ಟು ದ ಫರ್ದರ್ ಸ್ಟೇಜ್, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಸೆಕ್ಷುವಲ್ ಸೈಕಲ್. ಓಕೆ, ವಿ ಆಲ್ ನೋ ಅಬೌಟ್ ಎ ಸೆಕ್ಷುವಲ್ ಸೈಕಲ್, ವೆಜಿಟೇಟಿವ್ ರೀಪ್ರೊಡಕ್ಷನ್. ಓಕೆ, ವಿ ಸ್ಟಡಿಡ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್ ಸ್ಪೋರ್ಸ್ ಫಾರ್ಮಿಂಗ್ ಓವರ್ ದೇ. ಬಟ್ ನೌ ಲೆಟ್ಸ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಅ ಬ್ರೀಫ್ ಗ್ಲಾನ್ಸ್ ಓವರ್ ಸೆಕ್ಷುವಲ್ ಸೈಕಲ್, ಹೌ ಇಟ್ ಟೇಕ್ಸ್ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ದ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಆ್ಯಕ್ಚುಲಿ ದ ಸೆಕ್ಷುವಲ್ ಸೈಕಲ್ ಅಕರ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ತ್ರೀ ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್ ಸ್ಟೆಪ್ಸ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ದ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಸ್ಟೆಪ್ ಇಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ ಪ್ಲಾಸ್ಮೋಗ್ಯಾಮಿ. ಓಕೆ, ಪ್ಲಾಸ್ಮೋ ಇಸ್ ನಥಿಂಗ್ ಬಟ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಸಮಥಿಂಗ್ ರೆಲೆವೆಂಟ್ ಟು ಪ್ರೋಟೋಪ್ಲಾಸಮ್. ಓಕೆ, ಪ್ರೋಟೋಪ್ಲಾಸ್ಟ್ ಆರ್ ಪ್ರೋಟೋಪ್ಲಾಸಮ್. ಸೊ ಪ್ರೋಟೋಪ್ಲಾಸ್ಟ್ ಆರ್ ಪ್ರೋಟೋಪ್ಲಾಸ್ಮ ನಥಿಂಗ್ ಬಟ್ ದ ಸೆಲ್ ಮೆಂಬ್ರೇನ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದ ಅಂಡರ್ ಸೈಟೋಪ್ಲಾಸಮ್ ಈಸ್ ಆ್ಯಕ್ಚುಲಿ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ ಪ್ರೋಟೋಪ್ಲಾಸ್ಟ್. ಓಕೆ, ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಅ ಲುಕ್ ಓವರ್ ಹಿಯರ್. ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಸೆಲ್ ಮೆಂಬ್ರೇನ್. ಓಕೆ, ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಇಮ್ಯಾಜಿನ್ ಇಫ್ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಅನ್ ಅನಿಮಲ್ ಸೆಲ್, ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ ಸೆಲ್ ಮೆಂಬ್ರೇನ್. ಇಫ್ ಇಟ್ ವಾಸ್ ಅ ಪ್ಲಾಂಟ್ ಸೆಲ್, ಇಟ್ ವಾಸ್ ಬೀನ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ ಸೆಲ್ ವಾಲ್. ಓಕೆ, ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಸೈಟೋಪ್ಲಾಸಮ್ ಇನ್ಸೈಡ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ನ್ಯೂಕ್ಲಿಯಸ್. ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ರೈಟ್ ಇಟ್ ಡೌನ್ ಓವರ್ ಹಿಯರ್, ನ್ಯೂಕ್ಲಿಯಸ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಹಿಯರ್ ಪ್ರೋಟೋಪ್ಲಾಸ್ಟ್ ಇಸ್ ನಥಿಂಗ್ ಬಟ್, ಓಕೆ, ಹಿಯರ್ ಸೆಲ್ ವಾಲ್ ಇಸ್ ಬೀನ್ ಆಬ್ಸೆಂಟ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಸೆಲ್ ವಾಲ್ ಇಸ್ ಆಬ್ಸೆಂಟ್, ಸೊ ಓನ್ಲಿ ದ ಸೆಲ್ ಮೆಂಬ್ರೇನ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಸೈಟೋಪ್ಲಾಸಮ್. ಓಕೆ, ದ ಫ್ಯೂಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಸೆಲ್ ಮೆಂಬ್ರೇನ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಸೈಟೋಪ್ಲಾಸಮ್ ಈಸ್ ಆ್ಯಕ್ಚುಲಿ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ ಪ್ಲಾಸ್ಮೋಗ್ಯಾಮಿ. ಓಕೆ, ಇಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಶ್ಯೂರ್? ಓಕೆ, ಇಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಕ್ಲಿಯರ್? ದ ಫ್ಯೂಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಸೆಲ್ ಮೆಂಬ್ರೇನ್ ಆರ್ ದಿ ಪ್ರೋಟೋಪ್ಲಾಸಮ್ ಆಫ್ ಒನ್ ಮೋಟೈಲ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಅದರ್ ನಾನ್ ಮೋಟೈಲ್ ಸ್ಪೋರ್ ಇಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ ಪ್ಲಾಸ್ಮೋಗ್ಯಾಮಿ. ಓಕೆ, ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಸ್ಟೆಪ್. ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಕಮಿಂಗ್ ಬ್ಯಾಕ್ ಟು ದಿ ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ಸ್ಟೆಪ್, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಕ್ಯಾರಿಯೋಗ್ಯಾಮಿ. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಕ್ಯಾರಿಯೋಗ್ಯಾಮಿ ಇಸ್ ದ ಒನ್ ವೆರಿ ಕ್ಯಾರಿಯೋನ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಇಟ್ ರೆಫರ್ಸ್ ಟು ನ್ಯೂಕ್ಲಿಯಸ್. ಗ್ಯಾಮಿ ಈಸ್ ಫ್ಯೂಷನ್. ಓಕೆ, ನ್ಯೂಕ್ಲಿಯಾರ್ ಫ್ಯೂಷನ್. ಸೂನ್ ಆಫ್ಟರ್ ಪ್ರೋಟೋಪ್ಲಾಸ್ಮಿಕ್ ಫ್ಯೂಷನ್ ನ್ಯೂಕ್ಲಿಯಾರ್ ಫ್ಯೂಷನ್ ಟೇಕ್ಸ್ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್, ವಿಚ್ ಇಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ ಕ್ಯಾರಿಯೋಗ್ಯಾಮಿ. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಥರ್ಡ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಲಾಸ್ಟ್ ಸ್ಟೆಪ್ ಇಸ್ ಮಿಯೋಸಿಸ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಥರ್ಡ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಲಾಸ್ಟ್ ಸ್ಟೆಪ್ ಇಸ್ ಮಿಯೋಸಿಸ್, ವೆರಿ the protoplasm fusion occurs and then the nuclear fusion takes place, and when the nuclear fusion takes place meiosis takes place, that is reductional division occurs. Okay, say for example we as a complete human, we have how many pairs of chromosome? Okay, we have 23 pairs of chromosome, which in the sense means that we have 46 chromosomes, right? But when we divide it, we get 23 pairs of chromosomes. Okay, so here that is the 46 is diploid number and 23 is haploid number. And meiosis only takes place to form the haploid number of chromosome, that is the reductional division. Reduction is reducing the number, that is called as reductional division. And reductional division takes place in case of meiosis. Okay, so this is about sexual cycle. Okay, make sure you have this point into your mind so that we can proceed further. So now coming back to the next groups or the different divisions of kingdom fungi. So now we have taken a look. I said you kingdom fungi is divided into four groups, that is phycomycetes, ascomycetes, basidiomycetes and deuteromycetes. Okay, so now we can look over here. Okay, before that I would just like to remind you that I told you there are certain terms which you have to remember. One is hyphae, other is mycelium, cenocytic mycelium, okay, aseptic and septic. Please remember these five words so that you will understand the further things very clearly. Okay, so coming back to the first one, that is phycomycetes. Okay, first you have to take phycomycetes in there. Okay, phycomycetes are the one which are aquatic in habitat. And Renu, habitat is totally in water. Okay, aquatic kind of habitat, that is living into water, is called as is a basic feature of phycomycetes. Apart from that, they also prefer certain moist and damp places such as decaying wood. Okay, the wood which is fallen into river. Okay, one wood the yaudana river and bidetandra, a decaying process started. Okay, that is in water itself and that is moist. So here they prefer certain moist and damp places, and that's why we can say these are always found in aquatic stream. Apart from that, these are also found in moist and damp places. Okay, is it clear? Okay, next, moving to the next point, that is about mycelium. Okay, so here we see mycelium is aseptic and cenocytic or coenocytic. You can pronounce it as you want, but I prefer pronouncing it as cenocytic. Okay, so mycelium are nothing but those are the end part of. Yeah, I hope you are familiar. I have drawn that. This is hyphae. Okay, and end branches are called as mycelium. Okay, so in case of phycomycetes, the mycelium is not at all branch. Okay, which means you see very less branching. It is very clear mycelium. That's why mycelium. That's why we can call it as aseptic state. And also, mycelium is cenocytic hyphae, which means the mycelium inside consists of many number of nucleus, which is a multi-nuclear state. That's why we call it as cenocytic. Okay, is it clear? Okay, so that is about mycelium. Okay, next coming back to the mode of sexual reproduction. So the sexual reproduction in case of phycomycetes is asexual and also sexual. Okay, so asexual mode of reproduction occurs by two different phases. One is motile spores and other is the non-motile spores. Motile means moving from one place to other place. Okay, they might be having a flagella, they might be having a cilia, or they might be having certain condition wherein they can move from one place to another place. Okay, those are called as motile. Whereas coming back to the non-motile, those are the ones which do not have any such organs. Okay, they lack all the specialized organs. That's why they cannot move from one place to other place. So sexual reproduction occurs in two phases. One is motile and other is the non-motile. So motile state is called as zoospores. Okay, zoospores are the one which are motile spores, which means which can move from one place to other place. And non-motile spores are aplanospores. Aplanospores are also helpful in case of reproduction, but they cannot move. Okay, instead zoospores have to come near aplanospores, then only fertilization can take place. Okay, and then this is the mode of sexual reproduction. Okay, wherein this motile and non-motile spores undergo fusion. Fusion of these two gametes takes place, and when the fusion of motile and non-motile gametes occurs, there is the observation of zygospores. Or else, in common language we say, okay, when relevant to human, we say that fusion of male and female nucleus occurs to form the zygote. In the same way, we can say that in case of sexual reproduction, there are two stages. One is motile, other is the non-motile. This motile and non-motile stages undergo forming zygospores. Is it clear? And these zygospores are also different kinds. Okay, if the zygospores are identical, if two zygospores are identical, then we can call them as isogamous. Identical andre eradu zygospore same morphology, same structure anna torsidre, we call them as isogamous. If at all same morphology, same structure torsilla andre, we can call them as anisogamous or oogamous. If morphology, structure is not at all same, then we can call them as anisogamous or oogamous. Is it clear? Example, you can take it as rhizopus. Okay, rhizopus are nothing but these are called as bread mounds. Okay, you just leave the bread and after few days you have you just observe certain colored fungal like structures. Okay, so those you can call them as rhizopus. And there is mucor. Okay, and third is albugo. Okay, albugo is basically used in many of the other synthetic and non-synthetic chemical preparations. Okay, so up to here, is it clear? Okay, this is all about phycomycetes. Okay, you have to remember one thing. First is where they are found. Okay, next is the mode of nutrition. Third is reproduction. Okay, these three things you make sure you remember for each and every one, then you can write it down very easily. Okay, and here as you know their mode of nutrition is saprophytic. That's it. Okay, you can write saprophytic mode of nutrition is seen in phycomycetes. Is it clear? Okay, so now moving to the next group or the next division, that is ascomycetes. Okay, so here first thing is these are commonly called as sac fungi. Sac fungi, manchila. Okay, you can just imagine a structure of jute bag. Jute bag andre goni chila. A structure na imagine madre. Heng irtada sac irtadala. In the same way, they also give similar structure. That's why they are called as sac fungi. Okay, next is they are of two types. Okay, multicellular and unicellular. I hope you remember when I told you the general characters of kingdom fungi. I told you all the fungi are multicellular except one, which is unicellular, that is yeast. But being unicellular, it is placed in kingdom fungi because they are saprophytic. Okay, that means feeding on dead and decaying organic matter. They have cell wall made up of chitin, right? That's why we cannot neglect these characters, and that's why we brought back this yeast, okay, unicellular, and placed in kingdom fungi. Okay, kingdom fungi exclusively consist of multicellular and organisms, but only one is remaining, that is unicellular, that is a yeast. Okay, so next is the mode of nutrition is saprophytic, that is feeding on the dead and decaying organic matter. Next is decomposers. Okay, decomposers andre yavadara dead organic matter bididandra. Okay, just for example, if animal is dead, okay, that animal undergo decomposition, right? So these are the ones which help in the process of decomposition. Okay, parasitic, the lazy mode of life, being on the surface or inside the body of other plants or animals so that they can continue their generation. Okay, next is coprophytes. So far you heard about these three, but this one is new for you, coprophyllus. Phyllus is attractive, love, okay, everything. Phyllus is love, attraction for everything. Copro is fecal matter. Okay, so coprophyllus are the one which love the fecal matter. Example, growing on the cow dung, growing on any of the dung, cow dung agli, very outer fecal matter agli, the fungus which grow on the dung or the fecal matter of other organism so that they can gain their nutrition are called as coprophyllus. Okay, next is mycelium is septate. Mycelium, as I told you, the last part of the hyphae are called as mycelium, and mycelium is branched over here. Branched means you see much more complex branching of mycelium. That's why mycelium is septate. Okay, asexual process of reproduction include spore formation. Okay, how the spore forms? condition, they burst open and leave tiny mycelia into the atmosphere. Okay, this is a new mycelium goes, gets its rooting and forms the hyphae and becomes into a great new structure or a branching. Okay, this is how asexual reproduction takes place. Coming back to the sexual mode of reproduction, over here, in case of sexual mode, you also see sexual spores, those are called as ascospores. Okay, ascospores are nothing but those are formed in case of asci. Okay, as in case over here, you saw conidiospores. In the same way, ascospores are also contained in case of asci. And this asci help into the fruiting body. Okay, fruiting body is the upper part of, okay, this is the lower part. Okay, this is up to over here, you see mycelia. And this uppermost part is called as fruiting body. Okay, in case of fungus, you get two parts. One is mycelia and other is the fruiting body. Fruiting body is nothing but it consists of hyphae totally. Okay, so here what you can say, sexual spores are nothing but those are ascospores. But ascospores, and those are contained in case of asci, and when the favorable condition reaches, they grow into a fruiting body. Okay, example, Aspergillus neurosporia. Okay, neurosporia is basically used in case of many antibiotic processes. Okay, neurosporia. Is it clear of this? Okay, I still repeat, you can remember about where they are found, okay, what is the mode of nutrition and sexual reproduction. Okay, next, coming back to the third one, those are Basidiomycetes. Okay, Basidiomycetes are commonly called as mushrooms or puffballs. I guess everyone has seen mushrooms. How they look? Okay, mushroom, you can imagine how they look. Okay, and all mushrooms which appear like an umbrella, they are placed into Basidiomycetes. Okay, so here these are found in case of soil, logs, tree trunks, tree stumps, and parasites. So all these places you can find Basidiomycetes. Next, mycelium is septate. Branching of mycelium is more, that's why mycelium is septate. Next, asexual reproduction does not take place, but there is vegetative mode of reproduction, that is by fragmentation. Okay, a fragment divides and that fragment grows into a new body, and this is how vegetative reproduction takes place over here. Next is about Plasmodium. Okay, this is all about sexual mode of reproduction, which I explained you previously. Okay, there are three steps of sexual mode of reproduction. One is Plasmogamy, Karyogamy, and Meiosis. Very good. So here you can see Plasmogamy forms Basidium. Okay, Plasmogamy is fusion of protoplasm of two different cells, vegetative and non-vegetative cell, forms Basidium. Okay, say in case of fungi, there is alternation of generation. Asexual mode in the sexual mode in the asexual mode, alternation of vyavarta mode they be. That's why fungi are alternation of generation given. Okay, and that's why ye mode in Sikthanandra, say over here, asexual spores formation in the, that is asexual reproduction in the, but vegetative reproduction, which is also a form of asexual, that is by fragmentation is seen. Okay, either vegetative fragmentation after the law, and spore formation after. Spores are nothing but, in case of Plasmogamy, fusion of spores takes place and they help in the formation of Basidium. Okay, Basidium, that obviously spores under, they consist of cell either nucleus in the, okay, right? So, in Basidium, the gain after the nucleus in the, nucleus fusion, now karyogamy, karyogamy. Basidium, the nuclear fusion after the, that is karyogamy. Okay, and then here you can see those are called as basidiospores. Four number of basidiospores are produced at the end result. Okay, wherein they undergo meiosis. Okay, in meiosis reduction and division are two. Okay, meiosis undergo two. Meiosis is another one basidium bangi, basidiospores formation again. Is it clear? Okay. So I hope you can remember all these points very clearly, because first there are three steps of sexual reproduction, they only show asexual mode of reproduction. But in case of fungi, we know that there is alternation of generation. Alternation of generation andre enu, once the sexual mode aagthada and next avaga next asexual mode of reproduction aagthada. Asexual inda what sexual mode? Sexual mode inda asexual. This is how alternation of generation takes place. But in case of Diplomyces, alternation of generation enu kandu badrinda and only asexual reproduction itthu. That's why a different division was formed, that was called as Deuteromycetes. Okay? So here that's why they are called as imperfect fungi. Imperfect andre, fungi are mainly known for alternation of generation, but if they only asexual mode of reproduction ithe, that's why they are called as imperfect fungi. Next, asexual spores are called as conidia. Okay, conidia, you heard about it here also. Asexual spores are called as conidia. Okay, next mycelium is septate. That is branched, highly branched mycelium, which is called as septate. Next, mode of nutrition is saprophytes. Feeding on dead and decaying organ, parasites, lazy bugs, and then lastly decomposers. Wherever decomposition process takes place, these are found so that the process of decomposition is doubled. Okay, illi ee stage in the decomposition, ee stage in the that is the increase the rate of decomposition. Example, Alternaria and Trichoderma. Is it clear? So this is all about the different groups of kingdom fungi. Okay, okay. So if you have any doubts, you can ask me anytime. I'll be sending the notes of this particular class. You can copy it down in your notes book. And thank you for watching.